Okay, so we have Bob Roper here, who is the chair of IAFC Wildland Fire Policy Committee. Thank you for joining us today. We appreciate it.
Welcome.
Okay, so obviously we've had a really busy wildfire season here in Colorado. And I think the question is, you know, when it comes to battling these wildfires, you need help from the ground and also up above. In the air, are there certain aircraft better than others?
Yeah, for every fire, there's a different answer to that. When you're dropping water around homes, most of the time, helicopters are the best tool. So you have to find out what type of tactic you're trying to use on the fire. For a large ridge lines on top of a fire or flat areas, some of the large aircraft, the DC-10, the P-2s, or even the 747 have been great tactical. But it all depends on what the size of the fire, what aircraft is available, and how you can use it on the fire.
I understand there's this thing called the UE fire. Can you share with us what exactly that is and what are some of the challenges for that?
Okay. The wildland urban interface fire, it's called WUI, is actually when a fire comes down into a community, whether it's a single home or it comes into a neighborhood. That's when the tactics of the fire changes from perimeter construction, it deals more with structure protection of the homes.
Kind of like the Waldo Canyon fire, how it engulfed a huge community there.
Correct.
Right?
It's much more labor intensified for the resources that you need to try to be able to put a perimeter around all the homes. It takes a lot of equipment.
Okay. There's been this debate before talking about retardant, fire retardant, and also water, which is actually better, which is more effective when it comes to fighting fires. Can you break that down for us?
Yeah, water and retardant are really two different things. Water naturally is very cheap, and if it's nearby a fire, whether you use water scooping aircraft or tanks off of a helicopter, you can do a quick turnaround, and water works great. But the one thing with water is it doesn't stay very long with the heat of the fire. It evaporates as it's dropped and so forth. Retardant is used as a tactical advantage to put a blanket of gel, basically, on the fuel in front of the fire. That gives time for the firefighters on the ground to get up to that where the retardant dropped to actually cut the fuel away and put a fire line in. Retardant has to have the corresponding crews on the ground to be effective, but retardant is actually a different tactical use than water is, except.
Okay, so with all the wildfires we've seen, not only here in Colorado, but really all across the country so far this summer, are there lessons that we've learned from each one?
Yeah, I think nationally what we're seeing right now is, number one, that whether you believe in climate change or not, wildland fires are increasing in size and scope, okay? Number two, what we're seeing is that no two fires act the same. We're also seeing that the public's reliance on government to have a fire engine at every house is, we can't meet that goal, that expectation. And the final thing what we're seeing is that the public's going to have to be part of the solution to deal with the wildland fire problem. With the lessening of government resources that are out there, the larger the fires, the public has to be a partner working with the fire departments.
And when you say the public has to be a partner, what can we do?
Well, one of the things that public can do is this, is prepare their homes, know that they live in a wildland fire prone area. They can prepare their homes by doing certain building construction techniques to it, but the primary thing they can do is maintain their homes. Make sure that they take the leaves off of the roofs, out of the gutters and so forth of their homes. Then what they can do is practice what we call situational awareness. So when a wildland fire starts, and it may be 5 miles away, they're aware of it, okay? They're monitoring it. And so what they're ready to do is when the sheriff or law enforcement comes through and asks for evacuations, they heed those warnings and they get out of harm's way. So the firefighters can focus on extinguishing or controlling the fire and not have to deal with rescues.
Maybe this is another good reminder of having an emergency plan for the family, no matter what the circumstances might be, right?
Oh, absolutely. Whether it's an earthquake or a wildland fire, when something happens very quick, you don't want to be fumbling through what records to pick up, what pictures to get. So that's all part of the situational awareness and preparing yourself, your family, and your home to get out of harm's way.
Bob, thank you so much. We appreciate it. Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Thank you.